Subscribe and press the bell icon on YouTube app and never miss another update.
Good morning, everyone. I am Vaibhavi Mishra, a final year student of Media Technology Department, MIT Manipal. And accompanying me for this interview is a fellow classmate, Soumya Avasthi. Today we have with us a very prominent guest, Mr. Arvind Mardikar, General Secretary, AIFMP. Sir, it's an honor to have you with us.
Thank you.
So, we have a few questions for you.
Sure.
We'll begin with the interview now.
Please do.
Sir, to begin with, please tell us about your childhood and early education years.
Yeah, I'm from a typical middle-class Maharashtrian family. Brought up in a, what should I say, with specific social sanskars, the values of the family and all those things. And I was blessed to be the youngest of my house. So I was always pampered. I was taken care very well. And my elder brother, my sister, elder sister, and of course parents, they guided me well. It was a colony life. My father was working in a big company. So I had a lot of friends, a lot of fun, a lot of activities, specifically the social combined activities. So perhaps I can go anywhere, I can travel anywhere, and I can mix up anywhere. That was my upbringing. The values were taught to me, basically.
And what about your education? Like how?
I was an average student, to be very honest with you. I did my schooling, the basic schoolings and all in Akola, my native place. That's in Vidarbha, Maharashtra, Vidarbha. One of the hottest cities of India, non-desert area. After my first year science and all, I went for the engineering. I should have been in Manipal like my another friend, but God willing and whatever happened, I landed up in VJTI Mumbai. I did my engineering there, I did my mechanical, then further specialization on automobile and foundry engineering. So for the education also, I moved. I had to leave Akola, I had to go other places. By that time, my father, parents also left Akola and went to other place. And it was fun, stayed in a hostel life, made a lot of friends. It was fantastic, fabulous. And this campus is reminding me about all those things about my college days. I'm really happy and honored to be with you all guys.
So you became managing partner of Bhagyashree Phototypesetters in 1987.
Right.
So how was your work experience working with them?
Well, it's a story in story. With my background of engineering, I was working with my uncle and I was into mining equipment, sells supplies and industrial explosives. But for some reasons, I thought that I may not be able to continue. So I changed my line and I, with sheer coincidence, I came into this line. Because prior to that, my father had also left Birla Brothers and had joined in, shifted to Balaghat. And he started one Mardikar Associates into that rolling of that exercise books and then printing press and all those things. So from that, I took a clue that I want to start afresh. So with sheer coincidence, I was searching and I landed up in this typesetting this thing. That was one of the first machines in Nagpur. For a layman's language, where phototypesetting was nothing but a computer fitted with a camera. It was a cathode ray tube. I learned it. It was a different thing. It was full of challenges. And I'm really proud that entire Central India, we were known as the best typesetters for vernacular languages, specifically in Sanskrit and in phonetic English. And with many awards, the then Vice President Chankardayalji Sharma honored me also. And again, that was fun. I love doing anything. I have absolutely no grudges. And from there, I diverted into this other printing areas.
So what have been your hobbies and interests apart from excellency?
As you can see from me, I love moving around, making friends, meeting people. I am a foodie. I love, enjoy food, all kinds of vegetarian food, wherever I go. I love to know the delicacies, specialties. And you see, talking to people, you learn many things. Whether he's younger than you or elder than you, that doesn't make. And every one person inspires you in some or the other way. Likewise, I'm moving around in this campus since morning and I'm learning so many things. I don't know when I'll write down my memoirs that I'll include what kind of systems are followed in this particular place. So likewise, you know, that's how I am. And I'd like to be very honest. First of all, one should be very honest with oneself. So I think honest. I love to appreciate, I love to learn, and I never hesitate to say, I'm sorry that I made a mistake. You know, that makes you clutter-free. My way of life is simple. Be positive, think of today and go ahead. Because hard work, your honesty, it always pays. And that's how the life is moving on. I'll be very shortly senior citizen. And with authority and with experience, I can say this. That's one should really try in this way. The life becomes much easier.
So as the General Secretary of AIFMP, what is your vision for the next few years of the printing industry in India?
Yeah, little tricky question. I'll be Honorary General Secretary for next 7 days only now. Our constitution of All India Federation is like that. By rotation, we become the Honorary Secretary or the President or whatever it may be. So from 1st October to 30th September is my distinct. But yes, I can tell you what we have done with my President and team in this year so that others can follow it. We have stabilized a lot of office processes. We have made certain systems to be emulated and followed continuously. We have introduced many things for the training of younger generation. As I feel that we must be proud of printer, to be a printer, any profession is perfectly all right. So we are proud of printer. We want to increase this print education, make available the qualified technicians, which is the dearth of right now. So that we have started, a lot of new things have started, collaborations have started, we are meeting foreign guests also. And in fact, talking in India, we have ample of talent. Only thing is that we are not passing it on to the next generation, that is what I feel. A printer's son should become a printer ideally, no harm, because doctor's son becomes a doctor or a girl, something like that. So we have failed somewhere in printing because we have not projected printing as something extraordinary. In one of my articles and one of my speeches, I specifically said that printing is next to rocket science. It's written, it's my editorial. I sincerely feel this involves each and everything of science. You name it, civil engineering, electrical, electronics, chemistry, physics, you name it. And absolutely everything is involved in printing industry. So why should we be ashamed of? I mean, I really don't understand. It's a fabulous line. It's a creative line. Every day we do something new. So it's a challenge for the everyday. So I love this line. And I'll definitely tell younger generation, must join this, must see it to understand it and to make your life colorful, I should say.
So you're the National Vice President of Hindustan Samachar.
Yes.
Please, can you tell us something about the agency?
Oh, my pleasure. See, Hindustan Samachar is a multilingual news agency. It was born in 1948. Something went wrong during that period of 1975 and onwards, but doesn't matter. We were lost. Again, since 2002, we have revived ourselves. We are registered in Delhi. We have an office, full-fledged office in Noida. We have about 300 plus journalists and reporters and stringers working for us pan-India. We are providing news as it is in Marathi, Gujarati, Hindi, Uriya, Malayalam, Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, Assamese, Bangla, in Urdu also. So we have a lot of newspapers as our subscribers. We have a lot of portals as our subscribers. So it's a very challenging job. And one more thing I must tell, but absolutely it's an honorary job for me. Out of passion, I'm doing it. So the Hindustan Samachar is trying to give the news as it is. We are absolutely against the fake news. We are absolutely against the false news. We are absolutely against the fabricated news. So that's our mission. That's what Hindustan Samachar is doing. Working hard, trying it. A lot of challenges are there, but still we are there and we are hopeful that we'll be on the top one day. Because giving news in vernacular language, your own language, is extremely important in a place like India, where we have the main life is in small places, not in metropolitan cities only.
So like you said that you are giving absolutely unbiased news. How difficult it is in today's world to do something like that, and how do you overcome something like that?
Very good question. What is happening now, everybody has become biased. We teach our journalists, and we also follow it, that whenever I am saying something or I am reporting, I should not include my opinion in either way, directly or in subtle manner. So news that is something has happened here. Now suppose I make a news of the Manipal. Manipal hosted a Chalchitra function here. And then there were a lot of young people. We saw the talent. These films were this thing. All the good things or the realistic things I can criticize. This would have been like this. But should not have been biased that this one was extraordinary or this one was other thing. Putting it my views into it. But giving news that what you projected, what you wanted to see, that I have to see from your angle. And put it. Without quoting what I wanted to see it. That's the basic difference. It's little difficult, you have to practice it. Because even I do that same way. It happens while writing, we put it our own views. Like if I have to ask, describe about me, or I have to say about something, somebody else, then I should put my me and my I about it. I must talk about him. What about him? So that's how the very hair-thin line between the proper and unbiased and realistic news.
Sir, we'd like to you have been the editor for Printing Times, so please share experience.
Yes, 2 years back, suddenly I was asked that, Arvind, you have to edit this Printing Times. We are in little trouble and you have to ensure that. It was a challenge to me. But perhaps my background, as I call myself jack of all trades, I have moved here and there, watching movies, televisions, reading. I love reading, meeting people. So that perhaps helped me. I took the challenge. First two issues, I had to understand what to do it. Then, to be honest with you, I'm not very good in English. So I can express myself much better in Hindi and Marathi, my native language. So I had to take help of it. But I write my own editorial. While editing also, I use my brains. And of course, my wife and my daughters, they always help me. Whenever I make mistakes, they corrected me. So, you know, editing and bringing people to write something and then put it in proper sequence, proper way, proper made, one has to learn it. But now it's part of my life because my day starts very earlier, 5:30 in the morning. So I get ample of time and I allocate my timings accordingly, that this much time is for Printing Time, this much time is for my for federation, this much is time for my regular business and all those things. So you have to plan it. It's a tough job because meeting deadlines, timelines is always critical. So far people have been helping. Let's see what happens further. About Printing Times, yes, we have achieved something extraordinary this time. We have printed 10,500 copies and it has been circulated to 10,000 plus people. And I'm happy that Manipal also receives that Printing Times.
Thank you so much, sir.
Lovely. It was indeed talking to you guys and very best luck to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.